Good morning. My name is Catherine Awasti, and I am doing the Instagram Takeover. We're so excited. The Student Animal Legal Defense Fund is taking over FSU College of Law's Instagram today, and we're going to tell you a little bit about ourselves, as well as a little bit about ALDF. And first of all, my name is Catherine, and I am the ALDF president. This is Kiki, and that's Cheyenne. And these are my girls. And I am from Jupiter, Florida, and I am a 2L here at FSU College of Law, and we're so excited to spend the day with you.
Hi everyone, my name is Mallory Umbahagan, and I'm a 2L here at FSU Law. I'm currently serving as the Vice President of the Student Animal Legal Defense Fund, and I'm here to help Kat today with the Instagram Takeover, and I'm really looking forward to everything we've got in store today.
Okay, so to start off, what is the Animal Legal Defense Fund? So we are a student chapter of the national organization Animal Legal Defense Fund, which is an organization that advances and promotes animal well-being through the legal system.
So I want to tell you why I joined the Student Animal Legal Defense Fund. I have a strong passion for animals like most everyone here, and I wanted to figure out how could I combine that love for animals with my love for the law, and Student Animal Legal Defense Fund has been able to allow me to do just that. And also, here's Ellie saying good morning.
So like Mallory, I also joined the Student Animal Legal Defense Fund out of a passion for animals, but I also came to law school with the intentions of doing something for the environment, and getting involved with the Animal Legal Defense Fund has also been a way to kind of see the intersection between animal law and environmental law. So we're gonna start kind of getting into what we do here and start asking you guys some trivia questions, as well as having you ask us some questions about what we do here. Okay, so we got a question about whether you have to be vegan or vegetarian in order to join Animal Legal Defense Fund. And our goal is to spread awareness on how all animals are treated and to promote humane choices. However, we're not all vegetarian, are we, Mallory?
So while I'm not fully vegetarian, being a part of ALDF and taking a few animal law courses, including a brand new one we have this semester, has allowed me to make more humane choices, not only when it comes to the food that I eat, but the products that I buy and use.
Okay, so obviously I picked the worst time to come to campus when it's raining, but I'm dropping off a bin for an event that we are hosting starting next week.
So unfortunately, puppy mills are not currently banned in Florida, and we're actually hosting Kate McFall from the Humane Society next week to talk to us about critical legislation to ban puppy mills and much more. And we're also hosting a pet food and supply drive, which is why Kat is dropping the tub off at the school.
Okay, so that's another great thing about Animal Legal Defense Fund here at FSU is that we are in Tallahassee, so we can get a lot of local speakers to come talk about local legislation, state legislation, national legislation impacting animal welfare. We also get speakers from FWC to talk about the impacts of light pollution on sea turtles, and we even worked with a local attorney here to get greyhound racing, banning greyhound racing on the ballot, and that is a huge accomplishment for the animal law world.
So one of our favorite events at ALDF are our dog park socials, and these two are obviously very big fans of that. These dog park socials are a way for us to take a break from class and get out and get some fresh air and let our dogs stretch their legs. We usually have dog treats at these events, and we even sometimes order things like vegan pizza for the people.
Okay, I'll talk about the pro bono opportunities we have with ALDF here in Tallahassee. We partner with Pets at Litem, which is a local animal welfare organization, and I will leave that information in the next story. So with Pets at Litem, I was able to get about 50 hours of pro bono work done over the summer and actually into the spring.
where I worked on a case involving illegal kitten breeding with National ALDF. And additionally, with Pets at Litem, I was able to work with an attorney to co-author an article that was published in the Florida Bar Journal. So there's a lot of variety in the opportunities that will open up if you join ALDF.
So I want to tell you guys about the fellowships, internships, and clerkships that National ALDF has. I currently serve as a clerk for them. I started last fall and am continuing this spring. It's about 3 months out of my semesters, and they offer it in the summer as well, although I believe that term is a bit shorter. Our clerkships have focuses on different topics, whether it's legislation or criminal justice, so there's really something out there for everyone. And what I think I like most about it is I really get a day-to-day look at what being an animal law lawyer is all about. It really helps you get your feet wet and understand what those day-to-day activities look like.
Okay, so the answer is no. There is no federal protection for animals, and that's one of the huge complications for animal law is that states make their own cruelty laws, localities make their own cruelty laws, and so it's very piecemeal and difficult. As for the last trivia question of the night, that was kind of a trick question because the shark finning bill did ban exports, imports, and possession of shark fins. However, commercial fishermen are still able to sell them.
So I really enjoyed spending the day with you guys, and I wanted to go ahead and finish up with talking about two really important weeks we have for ALDF each year. The first one is Speak Out for Farmed Animals Week. It's usually in October of each year, and the point of it is to bring awareness to the lack of meaningful laws that we have protecting farm animals from cruel treatment. Usually during this week at the school, we have expert speakers come in, whether it's in person or over Zoom lately, and they tell us about different topics relating to that specific week. And so the other one is National Justice for Animals Week. This is actually February of every year, and this year it is the 21st through the 27th. And the point of this is to bring awareness to crimes committed against animals in general, so it's a bit more broad. If anybody has any further questions about either of these weeks, you can go to ALDF.org for more information.
Thank you all for spending the day with the Student Animal Legal Defense Fund here at FSU College of Law. Last question, how do you get involved? Well, you can follow us on Facebook. Just look up Animal Legal Defense Fund, FSU College of Law, and that's where we are.